Hi, I'm Yannis Roussos, the product manager of the Database Group, and I'd like to take you through what we are planning to achieve in GitLab 14.5, which is scheduled to be released on November 22nd of 2021. We are working on a few really interesting items that I'd love to talk about some more. Our top priority for 14.5 is to make all our database-related tools work with multiple databases. We are working closely with the starting group to support them in decomposing GitLab's database. The composition, also known as vertical sharding, relies on moving all the tables that are associated with a specific feature to a separate database. In our case, we're planning to move all the CI-related tables to a second database away from GitLab's main database. I have to note here that this update is GitLab.com only at the moment, and even when we're going to release it to self-managed instances, it will be opt-in, which means that most GitLab instances will continue to work with a single database and we've seen no changes on that front. But for very large GitLab instances, like GitLab.com, where you cannot vertically scale the primary database anymore by adding CPU or memory, this is a major first step towards allowing us to scale more. Towards that goal, we're going to do two initiatives. The first one is to update all our database tooling to support multi-databases. We have a lot of tools, frameworks, helpers in GitLab behind the scenes to allow us to work with the database. And we want to update all of those to know about multi-database, to be aware of multi-databases and work correctly when we have two databases. The second initiative is upgrading our background migrations to also work with multi-databases. Background migrations allow us to perform very large data updates, for example, millions or hundreds of millions of records, which if you want to do it in a no downtime way without taking GitLab down, what we are doing is to have asynchronous jobs in the background performing the updates. So in 14.4, together with the starting group, we have finalized a plan on how to make this work, and we have a design document that for updating how we're going to run those background migrations with multiple databases, and we're going to execute on that in 14.5. Our second top priority remains addressing the primary key overflow risk for tables with an integer primary key. I'm very happy that we officially in 14.4 we have mitigated the risk for GitLab.com. So that means that we are done, but there are also some cleanup tasks and some additional stuff that we have to do, like dropping some rules, some old columns, and some additional things that we're going to work on 14.5 and finally close this epic that this effort that lasted for more than 7 or 8 months. Our third priority is the automated database testing using production clones. This is also only for the GitLab engineering team at the moment. So we're still working on it. We're going to add more database advanced database testing features in 14.5. And finally, we're going to do a few additional cleanup tasks, like, for example, removing old migrations code from our existing release. This is something we are doing every year or so. So we're, as we move to new major versions, we remove past and old migrations, background migrations, and code that is no longer relevant, so that we don't have to support them. And this is also very related to the work for supporting multiple databases, because that means that we don't have to update old code that is no longer used to support multiple databases. Those are the top priorities that we're going to work on. And as a stretch goal, as an additional topic that we're going to work on, is the framework for batch background migration. This is the way this is a new framework for running background migrations that we built for while we're working on mitigating the primary key overflow risk. In order to do so, and because we had to update more than 8.5 billion records, without affecting the performance of GitLab.com. We had to rethink how we're doing those asynchronous background migrations. So we built the batch background migrations framework. So our plan going forward is to make this the standard way that we are performing all migrations, all background jobs in GitLab. And yeah, because we think that this is it has a lot of advantages. This is a framework that allows the jobs to self-monitor, automatically adjust the data set they are working on every 2 minutes, and adjust on different conditions, production environments without affecting their performance and more. And we really believe that it will help a lot in GitLab.com, but also in for most self-managed instances. But because this framework will also have to be updated to support multiple databases, we're deprioritizing it a little bit to support multiple databases for all our other tooling. And then after we are done, we're going to also start with working on the batch background migration general availability. But we may start working in parallel on this on 14.5. That's it. There are more details in the planning issue that I'm going to link in the video. Thank you for watching, and talk to you on 14.6.